Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. My dear brothers and sisters, assalamu alaikum jami'an wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. As a scientist, I often get the question, do Muslims believe in the theory of evolution? Does Islam accept this as something that is proper? Well, we know that the ideas of evolution arose from much of the work that was done by Charles Darwin, particularly in the seminal work that he did on the origin of species, and men like Alfred Wallace. What they described is a process called natural selection, in which if you have an organism that lives in a particular environment, that lives in a particular place, and that organism has a set of characteristics, a set of traits, physical, biological, physiological, that arise from its genetic code, that allow this organism to survive and thrive in the environment in which it lives. And not only that, but reproduce and pass on those genetic traits, then that organism has a great likelihood of passing on the genetics that cause it to be so suitable for survival through the many hundreds of years that forward come beyond the life of this organism. On the other hand, if there is an organism that does not possess traits that will allow it to survive, that will make it poorly adapted to its environment, such that it cannot acquire its resources, and instead it dies off prematurely, then that second organism will also not be able to reproduce and pass on its traits. And even if it does pass on those traits, then its offspring will also not have a good chance of survival and will eventually die. Over the hundreds and thousands of years of this process, you see that certain organisms that are suited for survival and thrive in the environment in which they're living pass on their traits forward. And that those that don't have the traits that are needed, their genetic code eventually dies off and stops existing. Hence, this form of natural selection or survival of the fittest is reasonable. It does not conflict with religion. And we understand that this process has been happening for many hundreds of years and many thousands and millions of years beyond that. Now, what about human beings? Well, there is a physical record in terms of fossils and what has been found that demonstrate that there were primitive human-like creatures on the earth. Those that walked up on 2 feet. Organisms or creatures like the Homo erectus or the Neanderthal. Those that not only physically might have resembled a human being, but certainly in behavior and primitive thinking were similar to a human being. So the question becomes, did we as human beings present today in this form evolve from this primitive human-like creature that existed on the earth millions of years ago? Well, the answer to this is that no, in terms of Islam, we do not accept this to be true. Why? Because what it does is fundamentally discount or remove the creative will of God in the process. Moreover, if we look at the definition of Adam alayhi salatu wassalam, our first prophet, the human being who came onto the earth, we see that he was not born of parents like you and I, like every other creature on this earth. In fact, prior to his existence on earth, he lived in another place, as the Holy Quran describes, and then was sent. Thus, we know that in the evolutionary process, even of these primitive human-like creatures, that insan arose because God willed it to happen and did so for Adam alayhi salam without having parents pass on some genetic code to him and to Sayyidah Hawa. And we know that this is what reaffirms our faith in the creative force of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Thus, when it comes to evolution, it is okay to accept and permissible, because it is reasonable, to accept the fact that there is a natural selective process. And indeed, that those primitive human-like creatures possibly arose from an ancestor that also led to the creation of apes and chimpanzees. However, we as present-day human beings, beginning with Adam alayhi salam, did not arise from those apes or from that primitive ancestor that gave rise to primitive humans and apes as well. Again, this is because that postulates that Allah had nothing to do with it and that it occurred spontaneously. We say that Allah is the creator and his creative force and his causation is the reason behind everything, particularly human beings. And one piece of evidence that directly points to this is the human mind or consciousness. Because although the physical body can clearly be shown developing over millions of years or changing over millions of years, There is really no great answer in science as to how the mind of present-day human beings evolved, how consciousness existed, how the function of the brain leads to feelings like love or compassion or these sorts of emotions that exist inside human beings, again beginning with Adam alayhi salatu wasalam. And that's why religion says, remember that it is God who is the cause of everything, and that without His will nothing can happen. The Holy Quran, it says, نَحْنُ خَلَقْنَاكُمْ فَلَوْلَا تُصَدِّقُونَ. Allah says, we are the ones, I am the one who created you, so why do you not attest to this truth? أَفَرَأَيْتُمْ مَا تُمْنُونَ. God says, do you not see? Can you not see? Or are you even able to see the microscopic speck from which you arose? أَأَنْتُمْ تَخْلُقُونَهُ أَمْ نَحْنُ الْخَالِقُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, did you create it, that source from which you came? Or are we the creators? Am I the creators? Allah says, نَحْنُ قَدَّرْنَا بَيْنَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ. We have decreed death for you. Indeed, everything will die. And then Allah says, وَمَا نَحْنُ بِمَسْبُوقِينَ عَلَىٰ أَن نُبَدِّلَ أَمْثَالَكُمْ وَنُنْشِئَكُمْ فِي مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. We are the ones who have brought you into this world, and indeed we are the ones who can remove you and replace you with something else or someone else. Hence Allah points to the fact that He is the creator. And although we can accept the basic concepts of natural selection, and that certain genes die out, and that over hundreds and thousands of years things change for biological organisms on this earth, we do not say that we arose from apes. We say that it is God who created us from His will, just like His will controls everything else. Ask any of your questions, provide us with your valuable comments, let us discuss this if you think reasonable, subscribe to our channel. I wish you all well. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.